YouTube, use the don't let somebody eat next month attack. It was super effective. You know, I got a lot of people that come to me on my Discord asking me the same question. Hey, Kneecaps, you watch JoJo? Kneecaps, you seen JoJo? Hey, have you seen JoJo's Bizarre Adventures? And even though I've already made a video where I list all the anime that I've watched, which, yes, by the way, it does include JoJo, it never fails that every other day or so I have someone asking me something JoJo related. But you know what? Since we recently just hit 20 subscribers, yeah, 20 subscribers, I decided, why not? You know, they deserve it. Those JoJo fanboys, they're gonna get what they want. Not only will I answer your question that yes, I have seen JoJo, I'll also rank the JoJo protagonists and also rank the stands from the parts that I've watched. You know, so which one's my favorite, which one's my least favorite. Okay, so first we'll start off with the stands. Now, I've only seen up to Giorno's part, so Jolin and whatever the hell that guy's name is won't be included in any of this. Okay, so number five, Jonathan. He didn't have a stand, all right? So he's just number five by default. Joseph, though I love him, is number four, all right? He had the most shit-tier stand available. I don't even think you understand. Just me holding a butter knife with my left hand would make me 20 times stronger than Joseph with his stand. And by the way, I'm right-handed. His stand was like being the last one to the cafeteria at lunchtime, and all that was left was the shitty white regular milk. Number three, Giorno's gold experience. I liked his ability that allowed him to just patch people up, you know, kind of like flex tape. Number two, Jotaro's star platinum. He just punches the hell out of stuff, you know. What's not fun about seeing some guy just, you know, break a dude's face into pieces? Number one, Josuke's stand. I don't know what it is, but seeing that stand in action was just so goofy, you know? First he beats you up, then it either disfigures your face or, you know, or your body or whatever the hell he touched into an even more disfigured state, or it could actually just revert stuff back to the way that it was. It was so funny. Okay, now we'll actually rank the JoJo's. Coming in at number five, I can already smell the burning of the sticks and the dirt from the pitchforks lined up outside my house. But number five, Jonathan Joestar. Part one of JoJo and Jonathan as a Joestar was the most boring thing to watch, or at the very least, the least entertaining out of the five JoJo's. You know, I was a bit confused when I first watched it, because my friend Marcus, the one that put me on a JoJo, he was just hyping up the anime like, you know, it was some sort of fountain of youth. You taste this anime, you'll never need anime again in your life. And then when I watched, I was like, what? This is actually just mediocre at best. And he was like, hey, don't worry, bro, it gets better. That was the first time he ever lied to me, all right? Nah, I'm just playing. It did get better, but part one in Jonathan as a Joestar is still my least favorite. Coming in at number four, Josuke. Man, I tell you, as much as I love Josuke's stand, Josuke as a JoJo felt a bit underwhelming. He wasn't bad, but he wasn't as memorable as the others that I saw. Like, honestly, the only memorable thing from him was like, you made fun of my hair, die! And you know, that's about it. And in fact, I actually checked while I was making this video, and his literal main quote on the wiki is, "What'd you say about my hair?" Like, are you serious? But Josuke felt a bit meh as a character, you know? Or maybe it was just the fact that Kira as an antagonist was just so well made that it drowned out any light that Josuke had as a protagonist. And also the fact that there was an already well-loved and iconic JoJo with him throughout his part. And believe it or not, even though Josuke is at number four, Diamond is Unbreakable is not only my favorite part of JoJo, but also has my favorite theme song of the entire series, my favorite set design. Josuke's outfit was also my favorite, and you already know that his stand was my favorite, but yeah, Josuke as a character is only at number four. Coming in at number three, Giorno Giovanna. I actually really like the way that they did Giorno. I feel like he was executed in a better way than Josuke, where, you know, though both of them don't do as much of the protagonism, Giorno felt more staple to the events taking place than Josuke was. I also like that, you know, though he was arguably the protagonist, his stand and personality allowed for other characters to shine. You know, you guys know how much I hate it when they give, like, one or two characters just way too much spotlight. But yeah, Giorno Giovanna, Number three. Coming in at number two. Now, when I say this, you'll automatically know who's number one. So, here goes nothing. Number two. Jotaro. I know, yeah. Jotaro is definitely one of the most iconic JoJo's in the series just because, you know, how badass he is. Everyone loves the Ora. Everyone loves when he faces off against you-know-who, you know, the person that goes Muda Muda. His part was also the introduction of Stans, which, you know, which was a really good addition to the JoJo universe. His outfit is great. The ending is great. You know, I'm sure a lot of people have him as number one on their list instead of number two, but for me, he's number two. Number one, you already know who it is, Joseph. It's definitely cliche to have either Jotaro or Joseph on your number one spot, but Joseph is just one funny dude, bro. like the first episode of his part, I was like, what is this man doing? Is he insane? He's like the class clown of the JoJo series. I remember times where I was just laughing until I passed out on the floor because of just how ridiculous some of the scenes were. And as zany and goofy as he is, I like the way that they blend him. You know, as zany and goofy as he was, I think he was actually the smartest JoJo combat-wise. You know, not saying that, you know, he's the smartest intellectually, because I think that would go to Giorno, seeing that he had to know, like, the chemical makeup and DNA of so many animals and, you know, human body parts or something like that. Don't quote me. But Joseph was always one step ahead of his opponent. Out of every JoJo, Joseph undeniably had the most amount of personality. That's not up for argument. You know, you can put your hands down, right? I'm sure a lot of you agree with me that Joseph was definitely the best Joestar and deserves the number one spot. And that's pretty much it. If I ever see even one comment asking me if I've seen JoJo, I will go monkey on it. Do you understand me? Okay. Have a good night.